From droplets from the nose and mouth, often when you're coughing or sneezing, and they land on surfaces, and you pick up the virus then with your hands. And if you touch your nose, eyes, or mouth, that's how you become infected. You can also pick it up by touching other people or by shaking hands and then touching your nose, face, or mouth.
These droplets can land in the mouths or noses of people who are nearby. These droplets are too heavy to travel far in the air. They only travel approximately 1 meter and quickly settle on surfaces. This is the reason person-to-person spread is happening mainly between close contacts. The exact time that the virus can survive on surfaces is not yet known. So it is wise to clean surfaces regularly, particularly in the vicinity of people infected with COVID-19. Hands touch many surfaces, which can be contaminated with the virus. You should therefore avoid touching your eyes, nose, or mouth, since contaminated hands can transfer the virus from the surface to yourself. When coughing or sneezing, cover your mouth and nose with the bend of your elbow or use a disposable tissue. If a tissue is used, discard it immediately into a closed bin. The most effective way to prevent the spread of the new coronavirus is to clean your hands frequently with an alcohol-based hand rub or soap and water. This will eliminate the virus if it is on your hands.
Some of them, 4 or 5 different kinds, cause common diseases among humans. Everything from the common cold to mild or moderate respiratory illnesses. Other kinds of coronaviruses affect animals. And sometimes, on rare occasions, we see coronaviruses jump from animal species into the human population.
The virus sits in the throat and the upper respiratory tract. In most cases, around 80 to 85% of them, symptoms are mild and they'll quickly pass. You may get a sore throat or a dry cough, and your throat may be red. As your immune system kicks in and you start to fight the invading virus, you may also get a temperature. Your body temperature increases as it tries to create a hostile environment for the virus. In other more severe cases, the virus can attack the lungs and cause pneumonia. This affects maybe 15 to 20% of people. It binds to 2 types of cells in the lungs and causes them to clog up.
We often have to learn much more about it. And one of the things that we question is, how does it transmit from person to person? We know that most respiratory viruses are spread by large droplets that come out when people cough and sneeze and stay aloft usually for about 6 feet in front of them. They land on surfaces and then can also be transmitted between person to person by touching those surfaces, such as doorknobs or other surfaces. Other viruses can spread in the air and stay aloft for a longer period of time in small droplet nuclei. For this current 2019 coronavirus, we're not yet sure whether it is droplet or airborne transmission. So we're erring on the side of caution and taking protection as if it was spread by the air.
Goblet cells that produce mucus and cilia cells, which have hairs on them and normally prevent your lungs from filling up with debris and fluid. Generally, most people recover from pneumonia, which can take up to 10 days to peak. In the most critical cases, though, coronavirus can be fatal, particularly for the elderly and those with other health conditions. In very rare cases, your immune system can go into overdrive. It produces a flood of white blood cells, which activate chemicals and can leak into the lungs. This, combined with the virus's attack on the lungs, damages the cells even further and can make it harder and harder to breathe. The heightened immune response can also result in organ failure and death. Some young and healthy people have succumbed to the virus as the disease is new and no one has immunity to it. If you have a healthy immune system, your body will be able to fight it off successfully.